Hello, this is your instructor again. It's time for our weekly instructor lecture, video lecture. And for this week, we're on our TED Talk speech, and we're now in the planning stage of the TED Talk speech. And I want to talk to you today when you're doing your planning about audience analysis, because this is one of the things that makes a difference between an informative presentation and a persuasive presentation. One of those things that makes a difference is how you treat the audience or what you think about the audience. Because a definition of this kind of a presentation is that you are going to be either changing your audience's point of view on something, or you're going to be reinforcing their point of view. So I want to talk about that just a minute, what that means. What this means is that you have a certain opinion, a certain point of view on a subject. And of course, that was the step you took last week, was you selected your topic. And now what you need to think about is, what is my opinion of this topic? What is my point of view of this topic? And so perhaps your topic is recycling. I'll use that as my topic for all of these things. And you need to know, does your audience agree with your point of view? Or do they not agree with your point of view? And it would really be helpful if you even knew to what degree are they in agreement or disagreement. It's even helpful to know if they don't have enough information, they don't know enough about your topic, or if they don't really care as much as you do about your topic, perhaps they don't care about this topic at all. So if you have your audience present, then it is really helpful to be able to talk with your audience or do a little survey of your audience to find out, do you agree or disagree with my point of view? Because the kind of persuasive speech that you're going to be writing will depend a lot on if you're trying to change their point of view, that means they disagree with you, or if you're trying to reinforce their point of view, they already agree with you. So your job is not to get them to think differently. Your job is to get them to maybe value something more, or perhaps to change the way they're doing things, their behavior. So once you've figured out whether or not your audience agrees with you or disagrees with you, then you're ready to move to the next step. Now, what if you're doing a video and you don't know if your audience agrees or disagrees? You're going to have to make some assumptions. You're going to have to make some educated guesses on what would most of your audience do. Would they agree or would they disagree? Or perhaps you're going to have to play it down the middle. You don't know if they agree or disagree or to what extent. If you do know, and if you can tell whether you want to change their point of view or to reinforce their point of view, we're ready to move on to the next thing, which is, what kind of persuasive speech are you going to give? You can give a speech to convince them, or you can give a speech to actuate. Now, to convince simply means by the end of your speech, you just want your audience to think differently. This is primarily for audiences that disagree with you, and you're trying to change their point of view. If an audience agrees with you, then what you're trying to do is get them to do something different. That's where the speech actuate, where the word act, A-C-T, is in there. Get them to act differently. So how do we know about an audience, whether we're trying to simply convince them or whether we want to get them to do something? Well, there's four different areas that you need to think about when you are analyzing or thinking about your audience. The first area is knowledge. How much does your audience know about your subject? Now, you should know a lot about your subject. You've selected this subject because it's something you care about and something you know about. Maybe you've had a lot of personal experience with your topic. But think about your average audience that's watching your presentation. Will they know the same kinds of things that you know? Or will you have to be more general in the way that you're talking about things? Maybe at the beginning of this presentation, you'll need to do some definitions, talk about, describe things for them, so they'll have an understanding of your topic that will help them make an educated decision. After you have thought about the knowledge issue, think about their beliefs. What do they believe? Do they agree with you? Do they think something is right or something is wrong? Do they think something is true or not true? So what is their belief? Now, using our recycling, the first thing we need to know is do they know what recycling is? That's the knowledge level. And do they know what kinds of things can be recycled? They might be surprised to know that you could recycle clothes, for example, not just paper and plastic, but there's lots of things that can be recycled. What about their belief? Do they believe that recycling is a good thing or is a bad thing? Do they think it's right to do or not right to do? Do they think that recycling does really, you know, help the planet, or no, it doesn't really help the planet at all? I think you could probably, on recycling, you could probably guess that most people agree with you that recycling is a good thing and that recycling can really make a difference if all of us do it. The third word is value, and that is, how important is this topic to your audience? Now, to you, you probably place a high value. If 10, on a scale of 1 to 10, if 10 is a very high value and 1 is a very low value, then perhaps you would rank your view on the topic, recycling, as maybe an 8 or a 9. Not the most important thing, but one of the most important things. What about your audience? Well, you can tell by the things that they do whether or not they value something. If they don't value something, they're not going to do anything about it. And so what about recycling? Can you do a little bit of research and find out, do people actually recycle things? And if not, then maybe that's what your speech should be about. Get them to actuate, to actually value something a little bit higher, and then to do something, which is the fourth word, behavior. What do they do or not do? Perhaps once in a while they think about recycling, but they don't do it on a consistent basis. So if you have an audience that their point of view is the same as yours and you're trying to reinforce their point of view, then what you'll be doing is you'll be trying to come up with a solution that is not just something to think about, but things for them to actually do. And perhaps that's based on value, which is what, how important things are to them. So after we have done our audience analysis, I think we're really ready to fill out our planning document that's for this week. So use the planning document that is listed there. Make sure to get that in on time by the end of the week. And then I encourage you to watch the two videos that we have for this week. The first video is all about language and the language we choose and how important it is. You know, emotions are tied in with our language and the word choice that we have. For example, you could call someone that is using a weapon and trying to help the people that they represent as a freedom fighter or as a terrorist. Now, one description has a positive, you know, connotation to it, a freedom fighter, you know, persons, for example, that fought in the Revolutionary War. I would not say that America, since I'm from America, that the Americans that fought in the Revolutionary War were terrorists. I would call them freedom fighters. But other people that are not Americans might call them terrorists. So the words you use and select can really help to persuade your audience, or it can really be used as a negative thing to turn off your audience. So be careful about the words you use and look that, you know, watch that video for that purpose. The second video is really a sample speech about looking at the introduction and the conclusion of a persuasive speech. I think this one would be good if you would look at the transcript, which is, there's a link to that just underneath of the video, and either take a look at that, maybe even print that out. So while you watch the video and you can pay attention to looking at the transcript and seeing how this is done, not only how is it written, but also how it's presented, the words that are used and the different techniques used in delivery. Well, good luck with everything for this week. As usual, let me know if this is something that you need to talk to me about. Otherwise, I will see you next week.